Every young at the lane to shoot. One and one.
And you can't see from this angle, but the fans behind the basket are making it very difficult for Young. And he missed the free throw. And Butler got it back, was hammered again by Jordan. Jerry Tarkanian, who could be a taste tester for Fieldcrest. There's what the shooter is looking at. And the Butler doesn't let it bother him.
No, as a foul shooter, and if you're a good one, that shouldn't bother you. But if you're like I was, anything bothers you.
You shot it pretty good, didn't
no,
you?
No, I really didn't. I was not a very good foul shooter, and candidly, it's just something I didn't work on because it's something that you can improve upon if you work at it.
Probably the most mental part of the game of basketball.
Yeah, it really is.
Vegas leads it by two. Clock is no factor yet. Hill with a nice pass underneath and a basket for Michael Lewis. Only his fourth point, but no two could be bigger. Traveling call. The Aggies will have a chance to take the lead. Watch this pass.
Yeah, if you allow people to get into the teeth of the defense, as you do right here, Anderson comes up with it. I mean, New comes up with the pass, but what happens was they let Lee get into the teeth of the defense, and if everybody collapsed on him, and New was wide open under the basket.
Just a great pass by Keith Hill. Hill with another great pass on the wing that time. The shot was missed by Brown. Cross court, Anthony for three. Underneath Butler with the gimme. 21 for Butler. We're tied at 74.
Well, Barry, this is how you like it. These are the kids that are putting it on the line. They're playing against one of the top 10 teams in the country. This is where you want to be. I love playing in games like this.
Absolutely. Terrific atmosphere. This is the only show in town. Brown! Don't ask me!
When it rains, it pours!
That was off his shoe tops. The only thing pretty about that shot was the result. Johnson with another acrobatic shot.
That's a man among boys right there.
He's got 10.
If the game is on the line, I suspect we'll see the ball go to Larry Johnson a great deal more than it had in the first 20, 30 minutes of the game.
Yeah, you know, it's really funny. I've been thinking all along, if this game comes down to crunch time, as it likely will, the two guys who have probably been most invisible, Larry Johnson and Michael New, could easily decide it.
Yeah, they'll definitely come alive. I expect to see Larry Johnson come alive. Now, Brown takes the ball to the basket. He goes up. He tries to draw the foul, and he gets away with a little bit of an offensive foul in the push away. But when it's going, folks, it's going well. And look at it. He wants the foul, too.
No problem. I knew I had it.
Now, Tark has changed his defense. He's gone to the defense that the Aggies have been playing, a 1-1-3, but he'll back it into a 2-3, just trying to get the Aggies to shoot jump shots instead of driving to the basket.
Let's see how the Aggies react. Anderson for New. And he traveled. This will be a night that Michael New will want to forget, particularly if Vegas wins the game.
Yeah, he would, if he doesn't come around here pretty soon, he would just as soon forget this one until the next time he plays Vegas and then try to take it out on him.
Nice pass underneath. There's Larry Johnson again. dance with what Brunner. Yeah. Johnson is Brunner.
And the pass is by Stacy Altman, the other person that Brunner.
Watch the trap on Jordan.
They got to keep the ball out of that corner because Vegas will go down and trap you down there.
Aggies being a little bit more patient, but I think it's the Vegas defense that's making them be patient.
It's a combination of things. The Vegas defense and the Aggies are a little bit tired. So this is, for the same reason Tark did, it's good that for the Aggies.
Hill for three. There were only 4 seconds left on the shot clock.
For the same reason that Tark went into the zone defense, just to give his players a rest, a little bit of different look, the rest helped the Aggies as well.
Vegas by two with the ball. Stacy Altman got the baseline, gave it back up to Hunt. 20 seconds on the shot clock. 2:49 in the game. Anthony has it knocked away, but a foul is called. Brown reached in his third.
The crossover right here, there's no question about the foul. You see right there, he slapped him on the arm, did Randy Brown. When it's going like it has been for Randy Brown, you try a little bit of everything, you get away with it, fine. You know, if not, you take the foul and you move on.
Yeah, he's had one of those magical nights, and everything he's thrown up has gone in, so why not try it on the defensive end? 2:44 left of the ball game. Vegas leads it by two. They'll go to the line when we come back to Las Cruces, New Mexico, right after this. On ESPN Wednesday night. And here tonight, an outstanding game, whichever way it goes. Great game, high emotion, great crowd, and two very good basketball teams.
It really is two great basketball teams, but I'd have to say this, that this is a game that New Mexico State, they have the best chance to win playing Las Vegas. It'll be infinitely more difficult to beat them, that is Las Vegas, in Las Vegas. So if New Mexico State wants to steal one from them, this is the one they got to get.
Long rebound out to Ogden. Great position on the boards.
You'll see Vegas try to squeeze the ball, take the air out of the ball a little bit. They've got a three-point lead here. They'll move it around and get a good shot, or they probably won't even take them.
Ogden looks in. And stepping in front beautifully that time was Anderson. Here come the Aggies. Hill reverse.
But the pass made that play. Randy Brown got the ball up just in time. Keith Hill had an opportunity to go to either side of the basket. The timing was perfect by Randy Brown on the pass.
17 for Keith Hill. And again, it's a one-point game. Butler. Too hard, got it back, puts it up, gets it the second time.
Well, now the Aggies have to be a little smarter on the people that they go out after. They've been going out after Stacy Augman, and Stacy Augman is not somebody to be worried about for shooting any shots, so they need to be more concerned about being in there with David Butler, keeping him from not only getting the ball, but getting second rebound opportunities.
Rebels also giving the Aggies a little bit of a different look on the post. They're going kind of high-low now, bringing Butler up a little bit further than they were, and playing Johnson down low.
And adding to that, they decided to run Stacy Augman in there, because with his long arm, he gives a bigger target. Larry Johnson is a wider target. David Butler is a taller target, and nobody on the Aggies team really matches up to David Butler. So you're right. They've decided to mix it up and let all three of the frontline players for the Las Vegas play in the post.
Let's take a look at that last sequence by New Mexico State that brought them within one at the time. It was a steal inside here. Anderson made the play, and a good outlet pass to Brown. And Brown, looking down the floor, gives it up nicely on the wing.
Well, see, he gave the ball in time. It was so that Hill could go either on the side where Hunt was or the other side, use the basket to protect himself and get it in. And it was all in the timing of the pass, because not only did Randy Brown have to get it to Hill, but he had to get it to him out of the reach of Anderson Hunt.
So the game will come down to the last minute and 38 seconds. It's been tied on three occasions at 2 and 19 at 70. Rebels had a big rebound a moment ago off the missed shot by David Butler.
You play games like this, all the little things count. A missed block out can be the difference in the game.
So now we're down to one of those times where every possession, of course, could mean the ball game. And you saw Nebraska State with only one timeout remaining.
And on that timeout, the reason that it's different was a great play that time by Greg.